With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Well, hello students. Now we're going to see this question. The question says that one dyne is equal to how many newtons? So basically, we have one thing you must know that dyne. Okay, you might think what is dyne? So dyne is nothing but the CGS unit of force. Okay, CGS unit of force. So basically, this is dyne. So if we talk about the newton, okay, newton is basically what? Newton is the MKS unit. MKS or you can say SI unit, okay, of force. That means what over here? Now we have to find out the CGS unit, okay, CGS to SI conversion. That means what over here? One dyne firstly will convert 1 newton to 1 dyne, okay. Firstly let's write down dyne, okay, is equal to n newton, okay. We have to do it by the formula of N1 U1 is equal to N2 U2. Okay. What is N1 U1 basically? N1 is the over here N1 U1 is equal to N2 U2, where N is the numeric thing and U is the unit. So over here we will write dyne in terms of what? In terms of centimeters and all. Okay. So one dyne, if you see, it is given by basically it is kg meter per second square in newtons. So basically this will come out to be kg, which will become 1 gram, okay, into 1 meter, 1 centimeter, okay, divided by 1 second square, okay. And over here we will have n newtons. So this will come out to be n newton is given by 1 kg into 1 meter divided by 1 second square, okay. So over here now what we have to do, now we have to find out n. So basically what we'll do, we'll bring everything over to this side. So n will be equal to what? Over here n will become equal to 1 gram dot 1 centimeter, okay, divided by 1 second square, okay. We'll have this and the reciprocal of this. That means what? 1 second square will come up, okay, 1 kilogram will come down, okay, and 1 meter will also remain down. Okay, now what we have to do, now we have to write in terms of centimeters and all, okay. Now we have to change it in 1 unit. That means what? We have to write in right gram in that unit. So basically in or you can say we can change kg also, but over here let's change gram, it will be beneficial for us, okay. So we will change gram. So 10 to the power minus 3 kilograms is basically 1 gram, okay, and 10 to the power minus 2 centimeters is basically 1 meter, okay. So basically 10 to the power minus 2 meters, okay, divided by 1 second square, okay. And over here we will still have the same, that is 1 second square divided by 1 kilogram, okay, into 1 meter, okay. So now what we'll have, we will cancel the units, okay. Kilogram cancel with kilogram, meter canceled with meter, second square cancel with second square. So over here we will finally have our answer that n will be equal to 10 to the power minus 5. That means what? Over here n was what? N was n, one dyne is equal to n newton. That means what? Over here we can finally write one dyne is equal to 10 to the power minus 5 newtons. Got it? So basically our answer will be what? Our answer will be option number B, that is 10 to the power minus 5. Understood? Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download DoubtNet app today.